Howdy. I am sitting in cave number 30, and it is a sublime sit. And I'm not going to say that I've been meditating because from the myriad of times you've seen the background, you know that I've done quite a bit of recitation or acting my monologue and singing and just exploring. And that's what it's about for me creatively. Sitting in a temple, feeling the sacredness of it, and then having my heart open up and exploring my creativity. So that's what I'm doing today. And it has been a beautiful morning. I started in cave number 14, which is a Brahmacharya cave. Cave number 30 here is a Hindu cave as well, and I'll have names for it later. And I spent about 3 hours, I swear, having people come in and having them speaking to one another, it's like a little chime. And the temple, it's like a key to a doorway. And I never thought that I would enjoy people interrupting my meditation, ever. And I've also had many times in my life an aversion to sound where I would wear earplugs. So this has been an enormous gift for me to embrace the noise, the sound, as something else. It changes, it transforms. And with each ping of this the harmonic scale, I guess, that's perfect in the temple. It rings in my ear and in my heart, and truly is a key to opening up those little spots of bliss where the atoms, as they're coming in through your nostrils, you know, they sit inside of your head, and then they boom, explode. You know, they can explode through your own thinking, through loving the energy that's coming through your nostrils, because we are designed by God, and we were designed to inhabit His spirit. The very first thing that He gave us was breath, so there you have it. In a nutshell, what I've been studying with my teacher for the last 7 years, and it's boiled down to the physicality of attaching your love and your appreciation. Buddhist concepts, but really any kind of praying, you know, and yearning to have a relationship with God. But once you realize that the spirit is actually in the air, then you will take those sips of air through your nostrils, allowing it to rest in your belly, filling up your belly with this beautiful knowledge, resonation, connection. And for me, I get chills every time I do breathe with intention and focusing on God and realizing that it is God coming through my nostrils. God made everything, so there you have it. All the many, many versions of religion I've gone through in my life boiled down to the nutshell of our physical appreciation of God on the earth. And how to reach God through the air, through the breath, through the oxygen. So, blessings.